Hello and welcome back to Opus Magnum Single Arm Challenge. Today we're going to work on a sailcloth thread. The last time we did this, we used two arms. Let's see if we can do it in one. I'm going to just leave that there. And use an old calcifier here. And I'll throw a binder up. And that's pretty much all I'm looking to do. So here's my thought pattern on this. This is gonna be just a little bit excessive, I think, but I'm okay with it. I was just looking at, like, how exactly do I want to do this? Roughly here. An extra binder right there. Maybe there. Nah, keep it there. So we have some room to maneuver things. So we're going to grab, turn, double extend, close, grab, turn, double extend, and then like pivot, close, grab, turn, extend, and then release, extend, grab, pivot, maybe? Let me check. So we have this little fin. Oh, yeah, just pivot. Close. And now here's where we decide. Does it take more tiles to turn? Or to turn? That takes three. This would take at least four, but honestly, like, probably gonna end up taking this one anyway, and it'll be faster to do it this way. So grab, extend, turn, release. Okay, extend, grab, I think we want to turn it that way. No, we want to turn it the opposite way. So now we have this, and we're about to put the next salt on. And then this salt becomes a hub. So it's like grab, turn, double extend. And like I need to see where that is. Because I need to be able to construct it. So let's first pivot it this way, close, grab, turn, double extend. No, just one extend, release, extend, grab, and then like double pivot it the other direction. Maybe a triple pivot. Because we're holding this piece. Okay. This is now here. This is a grass, and then, no, it's not. No, so yeah, pivot it one more time and add a grass. But, this does make me want to once more, close it, and then grab, extend, release. Extend, grab, pivot this way. Close? Yeah, that's right. That is right. Grab, left, left, extend, release, extend, grab, pivot, close, and then grab, extend, and now here's where fun comes in, because like we're going to want to turn this up. Yeah, that's pretty close, actually. Yeah, this is gonna be a long bit of track, but like honestly, I think it's what we want, so. Double pivot, and then we're gonna do like 4, 5, 6, 7 pluses. I honestly believe that. And it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think that's pretty close to what we want. It's a little, you know, it's a little stretch of track. But like, I feel like it does what we want. Yeah, that's exactly right. The question becomes, does it collide at all, at any point? No, and you see it just barely misses. That's why it needs to be so long. I'm okay with that. We could swing it around this way and then back it in, and it would be less track, it would cost less money. But I don't know if that's something I want to do or not. Okay, let me watch this thing work. Does it ever cross over the track? Yes, right there it crosses over the track. And that's the reason I don't really want to do it the way I said. I'll probably go ahead and just make a copy of it and do it the other way just to show, but so that costs 110 within 108 area. That's the key here. So copy this. Okay, and now let's, right here at the end, let's Like, let's turn it this way instead. And we'll do all this. Do a fourth one and then pivot it outside, and then we'll do the pluses. And so we do this. Didn't save much. That really didn't save much. We could do the pivot beforehand. Maybe that works? Let's find out. This is still going to be pretty tight. Pivot, turn it. Yeah, we add like one more plus to this. Oh, that actually is five. I had five instructions, but there wasn't five bits of track. There you go, that saved 10 pence. It's 100 instead of 110 now. But the area is 142 now. And that's the trade-off there. So I like solution 2 a little bit better. But that's just me. We're at 13 minutes, so we're going to go ahead and go on to the buoyant cable. The first time through, we used four different arms and a long little track. Let's see if we can do it in one. So this is going to be an interesting construction here. I mean, the fact of the matter is, we're going to need track here, that's for sure. And I think we also need one of these. So we're gonna leave the tip there, no matter what we do. Now, let's just start on constructing the thing, and we'll decide where to place this in the future, but for right now, that's what we're looking to do. So grab, turn, double extend, close, no, release, double de-stand, turn, grab, turn, double extend, pivot, now you can close, grab, turn, double extend. I think just one more pivot would be good. I'm trying to decide how many we need. So let's take it to this point and see where we're at. Yeah, and just one more there as well. So close it and then grab, Turn, turn, extend. And then this is going to be retract, release, extend, grab, pivot, retract, release, extend, grab, pivot? Not entirely sure right there. Pivot, yes, but extend again. Release, double descend. Grab this bad boy. Double extend. Probably pivot this way and close. Let's see. Yep, that looks good. And here you can see we're starting to infringe on this. That's okay. It's this one right here that we can't infringe on. So we just gotta keep an eye on that. And then we're going to grab, turn, turn, double extend. Pivot it again, release, double destend. Grab, double extend. Close, grab, double extend. And it was gonna be this, but we need to see, because this is a point where we have to fit it in. Oh, okay. Okay. I don't really want to move that piece. So maybe it's best to go back and get that other piece. Grab this piece and put it down. Could be. So rather than close here, let's drop this stuff. We have this. Okay. Let's pivot this out, pull it back, release, double extend. Then grab, and I think we'll be over the piece we want. No, we won't, because you didn't pull it back, man. Or you only pull it back once, and we want to pull it back twice. Yeah. That's exactly what that was. Pull that back twice, reach out, grab it. And let's just see the orientation. Pivot it this way, then release. Like so. Grab this. You actually need to pivot this way and then close. And then you're gonna grab, and you need to look at it, because again, we're fitting it in a small spot now. No, that's okay. You're just going to extend and then pivot it to the right. And that'll do it. The part I want to see... We're gonna go back here. And like, I just want you to watch these tiles. Ooh, see, that would probably hit it. You know, it didn't hit it, though. Unless I'm seeing this completely wrong, I think we could put this down on this row. Grab this. Nope, there you go. That wrecks that. Okay, I do want to see if I turn out here. Because we're done. We've created the thing. It's just a matter of delivering it. Yeah, if we turn out there, we're pretty much on it. It's just a matter of... I honestly think, I think it's gonna collide here. I think we have to add one more, but I'm gonna try it like this just to see what happens. So we've got the product here. Oh, okay. That's a problem. So move it back one, add another plus. I mean, I really don't, I don't like just splurging like this, but like we have to back it straight in order to get these two connections. So it just feels like that's the way this needs to happen. It's possible that I'm just, you know, not thinking clearly enough, but to me, like, this is the way to do it. You got, oh. Okay, take that away. Try that again. Yeah, it needs to be sitting on this, not that. And honestly, if I'm being honest with myself. Okay. Okay. I believe I can do it like that. And save 10 pence. Wait. That's not right. Like the old one. Like that. If the new one doesn't get, you know, attached to it, which is a possibility. You know, we've seen it happen a few times now. There you go. That's, yeah, that saves 10 pence. There's the two connections. Yeah, all right. So we are done with it now. Keep thinking like we could probably do less track, but the only real way to do that, and I guess I didn't think of this soon enough, if I built it from this end down, then we would have a hold of the back end. And so if we swung the back end around this way and we're like holding it here, we could theoretically go up and then just back and be there. Well, that's not true either, because the front end needs to, so we'd have to pull the back end the whole way back here, so the front end was sitting there. See, I don't really know how you would use less track unless you'd have to swing it around this way. Yeah, I don't know. I was thinking maybe if the binds happened further up. But I don't know how that would exactly work. But we got her done, and that's what matters. So that is the end of issue number 2 of the journal. We got the sailcloth thread, we got the buoyant cable. We will move on to issue 3 on the next one. And issue 3, like I said, looks a little crazy. This one shouldn't be too bad. And this shouldn't be too bad. And these two are probably not too bad either. But this thing, with all these connections. Ooh boy, that one makes me nervous. I might do that one first. find out when you join me on the next episode.